Well, it's that time. I mentioned in Sunday Morning Quickies for 31 October, Sunday Morning Quickies week number 14, for those keeping track and keeping score at home, that, yeah, I owe you guys a video as to why I prefer the 99 over the Featherweight. Well, not much I can do working on machines with this thing on my paw, so might as well have a chit-chat about the 99. Okay, this is a 99 that was made sometime after May 22nd, 1929, when its serial number was allocated. I paid $25 for it. Yes, 25 bucks. It needed to be serviced. That took me about 2 hours to do. On the servicing, I took out everything except the main shaft and the vertical rock shaft. Everything else in this machine came out, was cleaned, polished, reassembled, adjusted, put back together and adjusted. I did have to replace the bobbin cover slide. It was missing. This machine originally had a knee bar controller in it. That was gone when I got it. It was set up with a standard Singer button type foot controller and a 3-pin power module. It's a BR7 motor that's on this. Like I said, I paid 25 bucks for this machine. I put 2 hours worth of work into it. I bought a belt and a bobbin slide cover. That's it. That's all it needed. I will eventually have to replace this cord, which I can get that cord set for like 15 bucks. So I don't have a whole heck of a lot of money in this machine. And yes, I do have the complete bentwood case for it. I did add a light. There was no light on this machine. I had this vintage light that I had cleaned and polished. I rewired it. I added it to the machine. I added that weeks after I did the machine. Anyway, so my total investment in this machine is probably in the neighborhood of about 35 bucks. What did I get for my 35 bucks, and why do I like it more than a Featherweight? Well, first of all, I got a lot of these 99s. But what I love, I've got more space Under the arm. I've got more space from the deck to the bottom of the arm. I've got big hands. That makes a difference for me. More importantly, power. This machine, you know, we're talking capacity here, but also think of capacity as in power too. This machine has a 7/10 of an amp BR7 motor on it, and it is essentially... This machine is essentially the same as a 66. If you look inside, actually, let me move this jack out of the way. If you look inside this machine, all of these components, all the hook components, exactly the same as a 66. Yes, these parts are shorter, same beefy pieces. You could take these out of a 66 and put them in here, or put these into a 66, same part numbers. It's beefy. It's got a lot of guts to it. Inside the needle bar area of this machine, let me pull this off. Swing this around. Inside the needle bar, you've got a needle bar that is just as strong as a 66, the linkages are all just as strong as a 66. Some of the parts are a little different to fit this form factor. The presser bar parts are a little different to fit this form factor, but they are beefy. They are beefy as all get out. This is a very, very strong machine. What do you get with a Featherweight? You get a 0.4 ampere motor. Less space under the arm, both longitudinally and vertically. So yeah, you've got far more capacity with this machine than you have with a Featherweight. Featherweights are great, don't get me wrong. If all you're going to be doing is making smaller, lighter weight items, or if you're going to be like piecing together squares for a quilt, yeah, they're fine. But if you want to be able to do some beefy stuff, you want something with a little bit more testicular fortitude than you're going to find with a Featherweight. Now, yes, this machine is heavier. I haven't weighed this yet. What I'll do is before I go into editing, I'll get a weight and I'll put the weight right here. And I'll put right here what a typical Featherweight weighs in its case. It's a little bit heavier, granted. And actually the extra weight on this machine helps make it a little bit more stable because this has an oscillating hook which is going to vibrate compared to the full rotary hook of a Featherweight. That is true. But here's a trade-off. Extra capacity under the arm, both directions, and more punching power. If I needed to, say for example, if I had one of my window awnings in the backyard developed a tear in it or the binding needed to be re-sewn on, I could take this machine out, set it on my picnic table in the backyard, take that awning down, and sew it, no problem with this machine. Anything a 66 can do, this can do, as far as punching power. Featherweight, not so much. It won't get through it. So yeah, capacity, price, and here's the other one, convenience. Drop-in bobbin, 66 class bobbins, which you can find everywhere. I can go into a Walmart on a Sunday afternoon or a Sunday evening, and I can find 66 class bobbins. I have not seen a bobbin for a 221/301 class machine in a store, at least not in the last 10 years at all. Now, granted, somebody might have a place that sells them. There might be, you know, quilting shops. I'm talking about normal retail establishments that you would go to. Mass market retail, you're not going to find stuff like bobbins. You're going to have to special order them. Likewise, bobbin cases. Bobbin cases for Featherweights are finicky. I finally found an aftermarket supplier that makes a decent bobbin case that works in a Featherweight. A lot of people are spending big dollars, $80 for a guaranteed aftermarket bobbin case for a Featherweight. You want to buy an original, sometimes you're talking over $100 for a bobbin case for a Featherweight. That is insanity, my friends. So yeah, convenience, 66 class machine is going to have that over a 221 any day of the week. Now, like I said, this machine's been modified. It used to have an E-bar controller, doesn't have it anymore. It's got a regular foot controller now. That's fine. That was done before I bought the machine. I have other ones, other 99s that have knee bar controllers. I have other 99s that are more modern that have a lever type stitch length regulator with back tack. This is just the screw type. Those work fine. You might be saying, well, you know, Featherweights have reverse. This doesn't have reverse. I'm like, okay, well, what's the point? I mean, I know how to use a sewing machine. I don't necessarily have to have reverse to make a good seam. I know how to turn things around. I know how to back things up. And not every seam needs to be ended with, you know, with back tacking. So, you know, if you have a crossing stitch on that seam for the next seam, there's no point in back tacking. It's irrelevant. Well, there you have it. Those are my main reasons for preferring the 99 over the Featherweight. Price, capacity, convenience. Do I wish that featherweights were a lot less expensive on the market? Sure. I mean, around here in New Jersey, I rarely see them under $300. Occasionally down in the $200 range, they generally need a lot of work at that price point. 99s, I can pick these things up all day, every day, anywhere between $25 and $40. You know, this particular one in this Bentwood case, $25. Is it a great machine? Heck yeah, it is. This is a fantastic machine. It's got tons of power. I love it. You know, like I said, the capacity, the additional capacity, the power, and of course the convenience of them. You know, it's the drawback of this, of course, is its weight. But anyway, I'm not going to kick a dead dog because nothing moves but the fleas. So be nice to each other in the comments. Discuss it. You know, flame me all you want. Be nice to each other. And thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.